So I'm in the need of some TO-3 transistors, like this one here, although this one here is a genuine HP spare from Motorola. It's some sort of BJT transistor, this one's from 1988, so I don't particularly want to use this one. But this is what a TO-3 transistor looks like if you haven't seen one before. It's a 3-pin device, although one of the pins is actually the case. But I need a few TO-3 transistors for a project. It's just a constant current dummy load, so I don't really want to spend very much on the transistors for it, but I'd like to use TO-3 transistors as something cool and unusual, as using TO-220 transistors does get a bit boring after a while. Although TO-220 is quite a nice package. So I've heard that the 2N3055 is a rather common TO-3 transistor. So searching it up on DigiKey, we find a few results. Here we have one, unit price call and unit price $65. No thank you. Although they do have some more and 107, no thanks. All the, so in stock. And also exclude marketplace items because I do not trust this Rochester Electronics. I swear they mislead people on how many they have in stock. I've seen them with millions in stock, which is not feasible. But searching for that, we've got two left. One for 107, which no chance. And the other from OnSemi for $9.73, and they actually have stock. Although that's still way too much. If I was doing an actual proper project, this is what I would buy, but as just something for fun, no thank you. So of course, when you can't find something for a reasonable price on DigiKey, of course, turn to eBay. And here we have an eBay listing for those same transistors, and we get 10 for the low price of $4.84, although plus $2.64 shipping, which is much better than $9 and something for just one. But how reputable are these? Especially when buying from eBay, which doesn't really support per listing feedback, unlike AliExpress where you tend to get a lot more feedback per listing and per seller. So these look pretty suspicious, although I think it will be rather interesting to see what actually shows up. So I've bought them, and this is what showed up here. And oh boy, yeah, these look very, very genuine. Yeah. Let's have a closer look at one of them. Yeah, so this marking looks a bit suspicious, although it does say ST2N3055 and a whole bunch of other manufacturing codes. Which seem to be the same on all of them. Although, interestingly, comparing it to the genuine HP part, we can see that the thickness of the metal and the size and shape of the can is actually correct, so maybe there is a chance for this one. Although, if you've been paying especially close attention, you may have noticed there's something a little bit off about the top. It almost looks like someone has painted over the previous marking and put a new one on. Yeah, that's very confidence-inspiring. Now, in this case, it's pretty obvious. The paint doesn't match very well. Although, here's a trick. Many people, when making paints, they only really anticipate that people are going to look at them under normal light, so they don't really think about matching the paint for UV light. So looking at this under UV light, we can see, yes, there's a massive difference between where it's been painted. Yeah. And this one's actually rather good. They managed to get it on only the top, although here's one where they were a bit too generous with the paint, and it's leaked down the side. So let's see, maybe there's something underneath this paint. Not quite sure why they'd paint over it and not just rub the previous marking off, so maybe it's laser engraved. So spraying it with some isopropanol alcohol and wiping it, we can see it comes off pretty easy. So then I just submerged it in some more isopropanol and then gave it a bit of a rub more, and the paint quickly came off. Although, unfortunately, we can see underneath it isn't laser engraved, it presumably was just ink stamped. So I'm not quite sure why they'd bother to paint over the entire thing instead of just taking it off with solvent, but sure, whatever. It must be cheaper somehow. I don't really understand how, though. Paint's somewhat expensive, especially metallic-ish paint. Although, one thing I quickly realized was that you don't actually have to submerge this in alcohol to remove the paint. The paint can just be scraped off with a plastic tool, like this ruler here. So I'm rather interested to see what's actually inside this. So I took a pair of side cutters to it and just started cutting it open. I could have used the Dremel, but I didn't really want to get filings of metal all over this thing, because I think it might be interesting to have a look at it working without the case on. And now that we've got a little hole, we can see that, yes, there is actually a die in here, and it's a lot bigger than I was expecting. I was expecting some tiny little 2x2mm die that's out of, say, a 2N quadruple 2 transistor that they've stuck in here. But no, it is actually a reasonably large die. So this may actually be a genuine part. So cutting it into it more, just to take the entire lid off. And if you do go doing this, please be careful, because the metal ends up being quite sharp. And now that we've got it all off, we can see that the die is actually mounted on this little piece of metal here, which presumably increases the junction to case thermal coefficient. So they evidently haven't cheaped out on that aspect, so I'm wondering if this is actually a genuine part that's actually a different transistor that they've just relabeled 2N3055. Because that's a very commonly searched transistor, and people will maybe pay more for that. So I'm not quite sure what's really going on here, because this transistor looks like it would do the job. There's nothing really wrong with the size of the die, or the construction of the metal case. The wire bonding is a bit dodgy, but I mean, that's sort of to be expected in these sort of low-cost electronics, but I mean, it would still work. The wire bond here that's broken, though, that was because of me. So yeah, it's rather interesting to see what's inside one of these cheap eBay transistors. So I hope you at least learnt something maybe out of this. I'll just leave you with this thermal image, though, that I thought was pretty cool of it operating without the case on. And as always, thanks for watching.